Welcome to the discussion on ship stability solutions of quiz 2. Let us see one by one the 15 questions which have appeared in quiz 2. Let us discuss about the answers. Quiz number 1. In the absence of external forces, adding weight to one side of a floating vessel will cause the vessel to. Answers B. The vessel will list until the center of buoyancy comes back in alignment with center of gravity. So this is what we can see, a vessel in the condition of list. So when there are no external forces, when we add weight disproportionately to one side, that will cause the vessel to list. So that is the answer. So because of an internal reason, the vessel will list. And if there's an external reason like wind or wave, then the vessel would heel. So that is the basic difference between heel and list. Now moving on to the next question. For a large passenger vessel, the center of buoyancy and metacenter are in line of action of buoyant force at all times. That is the answer. So always we need to have the center of buoyancy B and metacenter M to be always in the same line. If the vessel heels, the line between G and B may change, but the center of buoyancy and metacenter have always to be in same line. So that is a big fundamental idea of ship stability calculations. Moving to question number 3, the vertical motion of a floating vessel is what we call as heave motion. So you can see here, this motion, the up and down motion of a ship, is what we call heave motion. So you must be knowing this. Basically, when a ship encounters a wave which is 180 degree to the motion of the vessel, which we call as head sea, that is the time when ship may undergo a heave motion. Now this is little dangerous because people on board the vessel will feel uncomfortable. There may be movement of cargo, there may be loosening of cargo, of containers, etc., which can lead to further dangerous consequences. So we need to reduce or minimize heave motions of a ship. Very important. Coming to question number 4, the stability is determined principally by relationship of center of gravity and. From the answers given here, the right answer would be center of buoyancy. So the relationship between center of buoyancy and center of gravity, that is something which is determining your stability and something which we need to keep in mind when we are loading or unloading a ship. Question number 5. At all angles of inclination, the true measure of vessel stability is always. You know, at all angles of inclination, we can always consider the rightening moment. The rightening moment is a moment which is inbound, coming from inside the ship, which is acting against the heeling moment. Now, you have a heeling moment because of an external reason like wind or wave, or maybe because of an internal reason like moment of mass, which is causing a ship in stable condition to heel to one particular angle. So when the vessel heels, the vessel in stable equilibrium will develop a rightening moment, which is against this heeling moment, which opposes the heeling moment. So we can always consider this rightening moment, the value of this rightening moment at different angles, as true measure of vessel stability. More the heeling moment, more will be the stability, and definitely this healing moment is indicated by the distance GZ, as we know. The weight of liquid displaced by a vessel floating in sea water. Now this question you can understand is nothing but the Archimedes principle. So the answer will be P, the total weight of the vessel. So when a ship floats in water, the weight of the liquid which is displaced, that is the weight of the liquid which is displaced by the vessel, should be equal to the total weight of the vessel. So that is the fundamental law of flotation as per our Archimedes principle. Question number 7. When the height of metacenter is less than the height of center of gravity, the vessel will have what we call as unstable equilibrium. Now this is a very dangerous situation because your heeling moment and rightening moment will be in the same direction. Suppose a vessel heels to the starboard side like this, the rightening moment will also be towards the starboard side. So even with a very small force or a moment, vessel may capsize. So this is a highly dangerous situation for any ship. Now moving to question number 8. Flooding of any compartment in a ship will result in serious loss of reserve buoyancy, and this will definitely reduce ship stability. Now reserve buoyancy is an indicator of ship stability. If you have a loss of reserve buoyancy, when a ship floods, definitely there will be a loss, a decrease in reserve buoyancy. This will definitely reduce the ship stability, and we have to know that dangerous approaching. Question number 9. The stability of a vessel is normally the greatest when all fuel and water tanks are full because the center of buoyancy is lowered. Now this is a principle which is used in submarines when you need to dive down or dive up. So here, by filling in your ballast tanks, you change the buoyancy force against the weight, so that will help in the vessel to go down or up as required. That is what submarines are designed for. Now moving to question number 10. A vessel's center of gravity is lowered when, you know, when you add mass anywhere on a ship, your center of gravity will have a tendency to go down, especially when the mass is under the position of center of gravity. So when your tanks are ballasted, your vessel's center of gravity will go down. So that is the answer for question number 10. Now question number 11. In the case of severe list or trim, because of center ballast, the counter flooding into empty tanks will. Now what is counter flooding? Suppose in a vessel, if you see a tank C at one end, say starboard end is flooded, then if you flood an opposite tank, geometrically opposite tank like A here, then this will result in a decrease of list or trim. Now because your C is flooded, the vessel will develop a list, or the vessel may develop a trim if you consider the longitudinal direction. So if you flood a counter tank, that will help us to reduce list or trim, and you will be definitely in a better position to fight unstabilizing forces. Now coming to question number 12. The horizontal distance between the vertical lines of action of gravity and buoyancy force is what we call the rightening arm. So this distance GZ, which is an indicator of stability of a ship in all conditions, this is what we call as the rightening arm, very important in calculation of stability of ships. In small angle stability, when external forces exist, the buoyancy forces assumed to act vertically upwards through center of buoyancy and through metacenter. So external forces will prevail when the buoyancy force is acting through center of buoyancy and metacenter. So that is the answer for question number 13. We're going to question number 14. When a vessel is floating upright, the distance from keel to metacenter is what we call the height of metacenter. So KM is the height of metacenter. It will be different in transverse direction as well as longitudinal direction. Question number 15. The height of metacenter has same value as height of center of gravity. In this situation, the metacentric height is 0. The vessel is said to be in neutral equilibrium. Even this is a dangerous situation and has to be avoided at all costs in operation of ships. So I hope this discussion has helped you to develop your knowledge or brush up your knowledge in ship stability. If you have any doubts, these questions or any other topic in ships,